Senators Foundation is important because we're a big part of this community. It
gives kids in the community the opportunity to play.
The Senators Foundation does a great job of being involved in a lot of different aspects of our community, and it connects the community to our team.
The Ottawa Senators Foundation empowers children and youth to reach their full potential by investing in social recreation and education programs that promote both physical and mental wellness.
The Senators Foundation helps my community play.
Tonight, we meet some of the people that the Senators Foundation helps, giving viewers an opportunity to learn what the foundation does and help support its endeavors through donations.
Senators Foundation has helped me become a leader.
The Senators Foundation is committed to ensuring that kids are given the opportunity to be active, engaged, and to feel good about themselves.
The Senators Foundation has helped me.
Helping families find the strength to deal with whatever life has in store.
The Senators Foundation gives our family a community.
Welcome to the Ottawa Senators Foundation Telethon. Now, after an eventful trade deadline day, this is the calm before the storm. Newly acquired Alex Burrows and Victor Stahlberg will slide into important roles with their new Senators team. Burrows is expected to start on Ottawa's top line with Turris and Hoffman, while Stahlberg will find himself in an all-important penalty-killing role. So here we are, hunkered down inside the Canadian Tire Centre. Yes, these are the lovely wives of your Ottawa Senators taking your calls and donations. Now, regardless of the score, this evening will be a winning evening. All we need is your help as we welcome you on set. Hello, everyone. My name is Tessa Benham, and it is an honor to be here with you this evening at the Ottawa Senators Foundation Telethon for the second year in a row. Now, throughout this evening, we're going to be sharing examples exactly how the Ottawa Senators Foundation positively impacts your community. More reason to pick up the phone, dial in, talk to one of these lovely ladies, and donate some money. Let's get a taste of those stories now. We'll give you a little sneak peek of what we will be sharing. In partnership with Project STEP, the Uvalle Center in Ottawa helps women aged 14 to 25 deal with everything from abuse, addiction, and education. Tonight, we will meet Nikki, a young mother who used the services at the center to help better her life.
The Uvalle Center really helped me to just realize my full potential. They really helped me to believe in myself and just feel like an everyday person.
Every year, more than 1,000 kids get to enjoy summer camp through the SENS Campership Program. Tim Lyon got introduced to camp as an 8-year-old. Now, 9 years later, his experience has helped him develop into a leader.
For a large part of my life, I wasn't a happy person. But the one thing that I always had to look forward to was each summer, I got to go to camp.
Al Arsenault is a volunteer ice maker who helps his community by maintaining the local SENS rink. SENS Rinks is a program that enables hundreds of kids and families to access programs and activities that otherwise would have been out of reach.
I get a lot of enjoyment out of watching the kids use the rinks. They're out there having a good time, and it makes it rewarding for me.
Roger Nielsen House is a pediatric respite and palliative care home dedicated to enhancing the comfort and quality of life of children and families in a time of need. Families like the Paravans.
Without the help of the Ottawa Senators Foundation and Roger Nielsen House, I don't know where we'd be.
Well, it takes a team to make an evening like this successful. Joining me is Ian Mendez. Ian, how about you inform our viewers how exactly they can donate to tonight's cause?
That sounds like a great idea, Tessa. And yes, so you saw the shots of the SENS wives and girlfriends working the phones. Let's put them to work, shall we? Let's put Tara Borowiecki and Julie Turris and company to work. Here's how you can donate. Here's the phone number. Pick up your phone. It's 1-844-GO-SENS. You can also do this online. Just go to sensfoundation.com as well. You can just pick up your smartphone and text the word SENS to 45678. That'll give you a $10 donation. You can text the full word Senators to that same number 45678 to donate $5. So here's the incentive for you. Check out some of these incentives we have, including an 8x10 print of the Captain Erik Karlsson if you donate up to $249, between $100 and $249. What about an 8x10 autograph picture of a SENS player and a game day use puck? That's if you go $500 and up. And how about this? $1,500 and up, an autographed jersey with a personalized message, maybe something like, "Dear Leanne, thanks for being a game changer in our community. community. Sincerely, Bobby Ryan. Maybe that would work. And the reason why I said dear Leanne is we introduce the next member of our broadcast team, Leanne Cusack.
Well played, Ian. It's so wonderful to be with you and Tessa tonight. This is a celebration of what hockey means in our community and how hockey really, really has changed our community for so many young people. Ian said that it's a youth game changer. Danielle Robinson is the president and CEO of the Ottawa Senators Foundation. This is an exciting night for you, Danielle.
It's an evening that we really look forward to because it's an opportunity for us to share just a few of the stories that come to life in our community because of all of the support that we receive from our fans.
And you constantly hear of the meaning through Roger Neilson House, or as we saw earlier, through the campership programs or the Sens rinks. And we'll be meeting those individuals, as you say, throughout the night.
Absolutely.
But this event means so much to the foundation overall.
Absolutely. We are very grateful for the kind of support that we get from this community. And so for us to be really accountable, it's a way that we get to share these stories and just give people a peek of the real impact and the real support that the Ottawa Senators Foundation is able to deliver back to this community.
And we'll show some individuals, and then you just amplify that by so many hundreds and even thousands more people who have been touched. We'll be hearing from Danielle later in the evening, but for now we're going back to you, Tessa.
Thank you very much, Leanne. Well, one thing's for sure, playing hockey outside is a Canadian tradition. Sens Rinks helps kids throughout the Ottawa region enjoy the game at its grassroots level. Find out more when we return. Welcome back. A new face for Senators fans. Victor Stahlberg, acquired before trade deadline. Nothing new for him, though, joining a new team. This is his sixth NHL team in his career. As for Alex Burrows, in his 12th NHL season, it'll be his first time wearing a different jersey than the Vancouver Canucks jersey. He knows who to make friends with.
Life lessons just through playing the game and having fun. You're in a situation where it's not serious, you're not in a game, you're just playing pickup hockey with friends, and you can try different things, you can be creative, and you're learning lots of things about friendship and work ethic and just things that have a meaningful impact on life that you learn through playing hockey.
Well, as many can relate, that was Kyle Turris talking about the great Canadian experience that is playing shinny outdoors, just throwing your sticks in the middle and enjoying your time outside. Well, Sens Rinks provides this experience for hundreds of kids and families across the Ottawa region by providing funding for programs and activities that otherwise would be out of reach. Now, as we all know, outdoor rinks need maintenance, which takes a lot of hard work done by volunteers, volunteers like Al Arsenault.
I think it's un-Canadian not to be on an outdoor rink.
Playing hockey outside is a Canadian tradition.
It's actually been an attraction for the kids to come out. It's a gathering place.
In my heart, hockey's always been the number one sport. Playing outdoor hockey is the root of it.
The Sens Rink in the west end of Ottawa is one of nine rinks in eastern Ontario and western Quebec that has been built by the Senators Foundation.
I love the fact that they actually reach out to the community and allow kids that are a little bit younger that might not have an opportunity to play inside an actual rink to have an awesome rink like this to play at. Makes you really proud to be part of Ottawa.
Without the Sens Foundation, this rink would not exist. We would have an old, rickety boarded rink here that would go away at the end of March, whereas this is now has become a place where the kids can come out year-round. Without the foundation investment in this, the community would be poorer.
Rinks like these wouldn't be able to run without the help of the local community. People like Al Arsenault.
Al Arsenault is one of the best rink operators in the city of Ottawa. He goes way beyond what other rink operators do.
It's very rare that I'll come here and not see kids on the ice or waiting to get on the ice, and they're anxious. They love it. They're full throttle when it gets out here. They've got their chairs going. There's a game going at one end. There's this figure skating going at another end. There's all sorts of activities, and it's just enjoyable to see. I mean, that's why you do this. It's a lot of work, but to see the benefit of those kids enjoying themselves makes it all worthwhile.
Being a part of the community is what the Senators Foundation is all about. Al Arsenault is proud to be a part of that community.
When I moved to Ottawa in 1989, the house that we bought was backing onto a park, and there was a rink there. And as it turned out, the operator was looking for somebody to take over. And so he gave me the opportunity, and I jumped at it because I remembered it as a kid of all the fond memories. I'm very proud to live in Ottawa. I'm very proud of the fact that the Senators do get involved extensively in the communities. I'm a big fan of the Ottawa Senators, and I'm a big fan of their foundation. I get a lot of enjoyment out of watching the kids use the rinks. They're out there having a good time, and it makes it rewarding for me.
The gentlemen who create a whole lot of skating magic. It's wonderful to have you here, Dino Daphniotis and Al Arsenault. And Al, I would like to give you the opportunity to set the record straight for anyone who has a backyard rink. You say those would not be your ideal conditions for flooding?
No.
The rule is what?
If I'm a serious rink operator, I wouldn't be flooding while it's snowing because you're going to end up with a bit of a mess.
But didn't it make for a beautiful television moment?
Absolutely. We also had one opening.
It is terrific to have you here, and it's terrific for people who are watching to be able to see the energy and the faces behind this program. Thousands of kids, would you estimate, Dino?
Bayshore is probably one of the busiest rinks that we have in the city of Ottawa. It pales to comparison what was there before, and it's just a drawing place for the kids to go out.
You mentioned in the piece, Al, what it's like for you to see the smiles and to feel that energy. Have there been any moments that, as you put a whole lot of love into the rink, that have melted your heart?
Absolutely. I get several of those. One that really comes to mind, I was out there a couple of weeks ago. It was early in the morning, and I don't know why these kids weren't in school, but a mother showed up with two young children. They were obviously just learning how to skate. I mean, they could barely stand on skates. But the first thing they did was reach out and grab shovels, and they wanted to help me scrape the rink. And that was touching.
Beautiful. Thank you so much for the work you do. Thank you for being here with us on the Ottawa Senators Foundation Telethon. And now people can put faces to their skating memories. Ian.
Leanne, thanks so much. What a wonderful story about what's going on in our community. Here's a reminder of how you can help out. All you got to do is pick up your phone and dial this number. It's 1-844-8-GO-SENDS. You can also do this online. Go to sendsfoundation.com. You can text the word SENDS to 45678. That will give you a $10 donation. And text the full word SENATORS to 45678 for a $5 donation. And, of course, here's a look at some of the incentives for you. In order for you to come out and help out, all you can do for $250 to $499, how about an 8x10 autographed portrait of a Sens player and $1,500 and up, an autographed jersey personalized with a message from your favorite player. And right now, we're going to kick off a power play. And what's going to happen right now is Steve Langford, VP of Marketing from Wesley Clover, is going to join me. And I love the fact, Steve, first of all, you're wearing the Sens theme tie. That's no accident, is it?
It's not an accident, no, Ian. Thanks for noticing.
All right, so here we go. We're going to put 2 minutes on the clock, and for the next 2 minutes, we're going to deal like it's a power play. In the next 2 minutes, Wesley Clover is going to match all donations up to $5,000. So again, pick up your phone. It's 1-844-8-GO-SENDS. And Steve, let's talk a little bit about Wesley Clover and the connection with the Sens Foundation.
Sure, thank you. So Wesley Clover, for those who may not know the brand, is a private investment management and holding firm. It was started by our chairman, Terry Matthews. People may know that name, certainly here in the west end of the city. Terry's one of the most successful serial entrepreneurs, starting companies like Mitel, Newbridge, Tundra, and many, many more. Part of what Terry does beyond creating literally thousands of good-paying jobs, he has his own foundation to give back to the community. We partner with the Ottawa Senators Foundation in some of the initiatives we conduct, and it's through that partnership that we can bring some better returns for the community. One of the best examples was this last winter. We initiated what was known as the Gift of Lights, which happened just down the road here at Corkstown in the campground that we manage, and it brought a tremendous outpouring of support from the community. And all the proceeds, because we operate that as a nonprofit, all the proceeds went directly to the Senator's Foundation. So that's an example of some of the things that we like to partner with and use the resources of together, our foundation together with the Senator's Foundation.
All right, I tell you, I took my family through the Gift of Lights this winter. It was terrific. Less than 30 seconds to go on this power play. Pick up your phone, and again, Wesley Clover will match donations up to $5,000. And I got to tell you what, Steve, you didn't get your wish. The trade deadline happened yesterday, and you joked to me. You said, is there any way, and this is kind of like Pierre Dorion joking that he'd like to trade Brent Wallace for Sarah Orlesky. You wanted me to be traded for Tessa Bonhomme. Are you kidding me?
Sorry, I'm not kidding. No, she's behind us here on TV, and I'm sorry, buddy, but you may be headed to the minor leagues if I get my way.
Wow. Okay. Well, it's a good thing this is all for a good cause. But I'll tell you what. How about this, Steve? How about you throw it back to Tessa? Maybe that's something we can call it a compromise.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks for this, Ian. Thanks very much. And now we'd like to throw it back to Tessa Bonhomme on the desk.
Thank you, you guys. Clearly, you're way above my league, Ian. When we come back, we'll meet a young mom who has used the Senators Foundation's Project STEP to help better both her life as well as her daughter's. Inching closer to puck drop here at the Canadian Tire Center on a chilly evening in Ottawa. Senators fans making their way into the Canadian Tire Center on the Ottawa Senators Foundation Telethon evening.
It's about giving back in the community. It's about being involved, and it's about supporting your fan base and being out and involved with them. And in turn, they support us. So I've really enjoyed my time here in Ottawa. It's a great community to live in. The people are incredible, and it's been nothing but positives.
Supporting community is such a large part of what the Ottawa Senators Foundation does, and Project STEP is a great example of that. Project STEP is Ottawa's award-winning community response to the need for support, education, treatment, and prevention for youth addictions. Now, this program's most successful endeavor is the Youville Center. The Youville Center motivates, educates, and nurtures young women and their children to be self-sufficient.
Sophia is such a brilliant young child. She's so compassionate and empathetic, and I'm super proud of her. She makes me giggle every day.
Meet Nikki and her 4-year-old daughter, Sophia. Nikki is one of close to 1,000 young moms in Ottawa who use the Youville Center. The center helps women aged 14 to 25 deal with everything from abuse, addiction, and education. These services wouldn't exist without funding from the Senators Foundation and Project STEP.
A number of people look at the Youville Center as, oh, it's a school for young moms, it's a child care for young moms. People don't recognize it's the treatment with counseling available every day. And without that, it's many girls, unfortunately, they go to school and they drop out. Having this center be funded by programs like Project STEP and Sense Foundation, like we wouldn't exist without it.
Nikki and Jenny began their counseling sessions over 4 years ago. Nikki was a brand new mother at the age of 17.
I grew up in a house where I was surrounded by addiction. My mom had a very bad addiction, so it got the best of her in the past few years when I became pregnant. That was the first thing that we had talked about, and eventually I was able to open up to Jenny about being in an abusive relationship. I didn't feel judged at all when I started talking to her about it. She's the one who actually got me to open up to everyone on my own terms, and just basically, I told her everything.
Through their counseling sessions, Nikki has gained the confidence to open up about all the struggles in her life. She not only got her high school diploma, but was named valedictorian of her class.
She's gained self-esteem. She has confidence now. She has great problem-solving skills. She makes wonderful decisions regarding herself and her daughter. She really is assertive. She's made amazing changes. She's not afraid to stand up for herself now. She doesn't put other people first. She still is a very caring individual, but she now cares about herself.
I don't even know where I'd be without being able to access such a resource, and I just wish everyone could have the same opportunity that I did. And really, it's just, it's so important. I just really can't imagine not meeting Jenny or coming to UofL Center. I think it's so important for girls to be able to talk to somebody, especially outside of their group or aside from family, especially when they're scared to share something.
Nikki is a success story. This success has not only helped her, but her daughter as well.
I already see it in her now that she is proud and she knows what it is to be hardworking. I try my best to implement it in our everyday lives and show her that you need to work for things that you want. And I feel like that's really gonna help her as she gets older to always push forward and just to want to be her own woman and successful.
And Nikki Norton is such a reason to support the Ottawa Senators Foundation, Project STEP, and the UofL Center. So many success stories, and it's delightful to have you here to share yours, and gracious of you to share such a personal story. We also have Jenny Strange, who is the clinical supervisor and a psychotherapist at UofL. And you two carry on like you're a couple of girlfriends, because clearly you've spent a lot of time together. Nikki, tell those who are watching just what UofL has meant to you now that you're thinking of applying to college and a graduate.
So UofL, just, it became another home away from home for me. Really, I just, anytime I just felt uneasy or anything, I went there, and I don't believe that I would be half the woman I am today without it. When I first came there, I was just, I don't even remember that girl anymore. And now I have so many goals I have set for myself, and I would have never pictured this.
And did you feel that Jenny saw that nugget of you that is the you now back then?
Definitely. At first I never wanted to even take counseling, and then she just put me in it, nonchalantly.
Okay, what I just love so much is Jenny, you are constantly sparkling, but when you talk about Nikki and the other graduates of UofL, you just ooze joy.
Well, it was amazing seeing Nikki graduate because she was also valedictorian. So I was just so proud, because when she first came into counseling, as she said, she didn't really want to be there, and she wasn't even sure like how much she should share. And now, well, by the end of it, she was sharing everything, and she had made so many changes. Like, I couldn't be more proud of Nikki.
Well, we're really glad that you shared your success with us, because this is a success of our community and a success of the Ottawa Senators Foundation, Ian, and that is why we're here.
Thanks so much, Leanne. And yeah, we're so fortunate to have Project STEP and the UofL Center as part of our community. And you can see behind me the wives and girlfriends, they're busy, but we want to make them even busier. Pick up the phone, open your hearts and your wallets. Here's what you have to do. You can dial 1-844-8-GO-SENDS. You can go online to thesendsfoundation.com. You can also text the word SENDS to 45678 to donate $10. Text the word SENATORS to 45678 to donate $5. And in terms of incentives for you, an 8x10 print of Erik Karlsson if you donate up to $249. How about 500 and up? An 8x10 autographed portrait of a Sens player. Then a jersey, an autographed jersey with a personalized message from your favorite player. Maybe something like, "Dear Tessa, thanks for being an Ohio State fan. Sincerely, Ryan DeZingle." Maybe, just maybe, Tessa, that would be your personalized message that you would pick.
Hey, I'd take it. Absolutely, without a doubt, I would accept that jersey. Well, one player that we thought was going to be moved on trade deadline day is not. Matt Duchene remains a Colorado Avalanche as he gets prepped for tonight's game. Now, two of the newest members of the Sens organization get to make their debut on their new team. Puck drop just over 30 minutes away. We'll set you up when we return. Well, it's that time. First time in their new jerseys. Welcome home, fellas. Alex Burrows and Victor Stahlberg step onto the ice for the first time officially as Ottawa Senators on game day.
Now, as I'm sure you all know, the Ottawa Senators were very busy leading up to the trade deadline day. Four acquisitions, four new faces, only two of them in the lineup tonight, that obviously being Victor Stahlberg and Alex Burrows. Alex Burrows just happens to be standing by with our very own Brent Wallace.
Alex, your first time in 823 NHL games playing with a different team. What's it feel like?
It's a little weird, that's for sure, but I'm really looking forward. I think this team has got a lot of upsides, and I think I'll fit in perfectly, so hopefully we can get a big win tonight.
You talked a lot about your family being able to come see you more and watch the games more. They'll be here tonight. What's it feel? What's it mean to have them in the crowd?
Well, every time we come out east, they always like to follow him around. They've been so supportive throughout the years, so hopefully we can get a big 2 points and put on a good show for them.
Thanks, Alex.
Thank you. Anytime.
Well, game time very short ways away. Victor Stahlberg and Alex Burrows some time to work out those new team jitters as they get set for tonight's matchup against the Colorado Avalanche, a team we thought was going to make moves, but no, Landeskog and Duchesne staying right where they are. All right, every year, more than 1,000 kids get to enjoy summer camp through the Sens Campership Foundation. Still to come, we meet a 17-year-old who has used the program to become a leader. Craig Anderson getting some reps in as he'll be the starting goaltender for the Ottawa Senators here on Ottawa Senators Foundation Telethon evening. How about Gabriel Landeskog? Still wearing the C and the Avs jersey. Matt Duchesne said they were stepping on eggshells yesterday. Everybody a little bit worried they were going to get moved, but no, that is not the case. All right, Ian. Over to you. Talk to us a little bit here.
All right, Tessa. Here's how you can donate. Pick up your phone. It's 1-844-8-GO-SENS. Online, you can go to thesensfoundation.com. You can also pick up your smartphone and text the word SENS to 45678 to donate $10. Text the full word SENATORS to 45678 to donate $5. And we're going to incentivize this for you. Checked out some of the things you could get for $100 to $249, an 8x10 print of the captain, Erik Karlsson. An 8x10 hand autograph portrait of a Sens player if you go $250 to $499, $500 and up. How about an 8x10 autograph portrait of a Sens player and a game day use puck, and then $1,500. How about this? An autographed jersey with a personalized message from your favorite player from the Ottawa Senators. Again, the phone number is 1-844-8-GO-SENS, and we're all set to kick off another power play. This one brought to you by Pizza Pizza, and a big thanks to Pat Finelli and all the good folks at Pizza Pizza. We're going to kick off the power play, and during this power play, Pizza Pizza is going to match all donations. So you want to do a double good? Pick up the phone right now. We're going to start the clock, and we're going to bring in somebody. Maybe Vern White, you can show the folks at home what the back of your jersey says. Number one Senator, and it's one of the rare things that actually is accurate, and it's true because Vern White is, in fact, a Senator, but you're also part of the Sens Foundation. Vern White, I know you wanted to talk about Project STEP, and it's very timely, isn't it, right now?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, since the very beginning of STEP, which is Support, Treatment, Education, Prevention, the Ottawa Sens Foundation has been a spectacular supporter of the program, kickstarting with $1 million gift in the beginning, providing both two drug treatment centers in the city and education programs in every high school. And I don't think we've ever been at a time that's as difficult for us as a city when it comes to addiction as we are right now, as we're being hit with the opioid and fentanyl crisis that is, I think you're bringing to the forefront the importance of the Sens Foundation and the importance of everyone in this community and the gift they can give to try and help us combat this this challenge that we're facing as families and as communities.
Again, this is a Pizza Pizza power play. Until that clock hits zero, Pizza Pizza is going to match all donations here to help out the Sens Foundation. Vern White is a senator. You also were the police chief here in Ottawa, so that's why you know so much about this issue in our community. We've got about 45 seconds left on the clock, Vern, but we're not talking about 19 and 20 year olds here. This is what's been really scary in our community. We're talking about kids as young as 10, 11, and 12.
Now, we have children involved here, and you know, a lot of them are getting involved in drugs that they don't even realize, and they're taking something that they believe is something else. And to be fair, you know, I think many people think it's someone else's family. It could be yours, mine, it could be my community, your community. It has no demographic, no socioeconomic, and to be fair, it has no race. I think we're all facing this problem together. I think we can work on this together.
All right, and a big thanks to Pizza Pizza and Senator Vern White. Thanks so much for this.
Thanks to Pizza Pizza. Thank you very much, sir.
I think there's a lot of different good leaders out there. Everybody's different and leads in different ways. So I don't think there's a correct answer to exactly what a good leader is, but I think it's someone that is always there and speaks up in times when they're not going that well.
So, Sam, did you...
Oh, that was Sens captain Erik Karlsson, who has developed into quite the leader for the Ottawa Senators. Leadership skills are actually a very good asset to have. Sens Campership Program sends over 1,000 Ottawa youth age 4 to 17 to summer camp every year to allow these kids to develop these skills. Take Tim Lyon, for instance. He was first introduced to the camp at the age of 8. Now, 9 years later, he shares how his experiences helped develop him into a leader.
I think it's the camp magic. It's not really describable. You only experience it if you go to camp yourself. It was just this world that I'd never been introduced to before. And I got to meet a lot of new people, and I was kind of getting this crazy experience that I'd never had anywhere else.
Every year, more than 1,000 kids get to enjoy summer camp through the Sens Campership Program. Tash Raposo, Outdoor Education and Youth Leadership Manager for the Boys and Girls Club of Ottawa, knows firsthand what camp can do for young people.
I think the connections that you make and the relationships that you build, it becomes one big family. It becomes one big learning opportunity for them where they feel invited, included, and it becomes a culture of just community.
Tim Lyon started attending Camp Smitty at the age of 9. Now, 8 years later, Tash Raposo has watched him become a leader.
He teaches, he encourages, he does everything that he can do to make all these kids experiences once in a lifetime and wanting them to come back every single summer.
Wow. As a counselor, it was awesome. It was an amazing feeling because that thing that I had wanted to be a counselor and give that magic back to the kids was finally something that I could do, and I cherished every single moment of it.
Since its inception, the Sens Campership Program has provided more than 15,000 days of camp for deserving kids like Tim. He is an example of what can happen when kids are given an opportunity.
The program helped him to really acknowledge all of his strengths and acknowledge everything that he can accomplish and really put that into practice and give him the confidence to say, I'm a leader, I'm capable, and I want everybody to be the same way and feel the exact same way that I do.
Camp has meant everything to me from the day I stepped off the bus. I want to eventually become camp director, and I want to work with Camp Smitty to continue bringing in youth and continue giving them that same experience that I had.
What a treat it was to watch your story with you, Tim, because Tim just kept saying, that's Jeremy, that's Mason. You were really excited to see all of the kids who were having such a good time. Great to have you here, Tash Raposo and Tim Lyon. And, I mean, we heard in the story the meaning of places like that.
Yeah.
For you, I guess it's sharing the joy ongoing with kids.
Yeah, absolutely. It's really about the camp magic for me. Camp magic is something that's really, I find, inexplicable. You have to experience it, and it's just such an amazing thing for kids. It gives them opportunity, and they get to really, really learn a lot about life, and they have a great time.
And I know there's a lot of gratitude for the Sens Foundation and all of the people who donate to make something like this possible for kids who wouldn't have the chance to experience these memories.
100%. We have so many children who get this opportunity through the Sens Camperships, and it really makes a huge difference. And they know, the parents know, and they feel it when they're there.
Oh, well, it is great to spend time with you, and I can tell you are an amazing counselor. I don't know if Brent Wallace has ever been to camp, but we can ask him right now. Brent.
Thanks very much, Leanne. I'm joined now by Senators President Tom Anselmi. Tom, I know you've only been here a short while, but what have you seen that's impressed you about the Ottawa Senators Foundation?
You know what? This foundation actually has a reputation to be one of the great ones around the league. Raised a lot of money, does some great stuff. You know, I remember I was part of Rose Cherry Home in Milton, and we used to look at Rogers House as a great example of how to do a hospice. So this organization does great, great work. Minor hockey, you name it. It's real impressive, and really happy to be part of it.
I know that you're on the arm of it. That's the charity arm of the Ottawa Senators Foundation. But will you be looking to grow it as you take over here at the helm?
Well, maybe less about growth and just more about really understanding what we do and how do we do it as well or better. You know, I already know that it's a foundation that's one of the biggest in the NHL as far as dollars raised. So it's really about, are we doing the right things? Are we doing what this community really needs? You know, things evolve. And so let's just make sure we're doing it as best as we can and as effectively as we can.
Not only a big night off the ice with the foundation, but also on the ice, new players. Your thoughts on that, the buzz is now being created around this team?
Well, it's great. I mean, it's a playoff run, and anytime you're involved in the playoff run, it's fun to be part of. We're seeing it in the building getting filled up every night, and just fun to be back into it and be part of it. This is a really good hockey team, real likable hockey team too, you know, and just a great group of guys.
Thanks very much, Tom.
Anytime.
Tessa?
Always nice to have Tom and Selnick back involved in hockey. Well, the Roger Neilson House helps families in need. When we return, we'll meet a family who has used that support to get through difficult times. That's next on the Sens Foundation Telethon. Welcome back to the nation's capital on what is going to be an amazing evening. Thanks to all of you who are calling in and donating to the Ottawa Senators Foundation Telethon. Keep those phones ringing.
Roger Neilson House is a place for families, and so we're a family, and so it's important for our family and our children to know that there are places like this in our community.
They're just tremendous families, and what they go through on a day-to-day basis, it's tough, but to have the respite and the palliative care that give their kids the proper care that they need, and to see it firsthand, it's remarkable.
Well, longtime Senators forward Chris Neal and his wife Caitlin have been involved in the Roger Neilson House for many years. Now the Roger Neilson House is a pediatric respite and palliative care home, creating comfort for families and their children in a time of need. Families like the Paravans.
So Matthew, from the time he was young, was a very outgoing, happy, silly, practical joker. He loved sports, watching sports, playing sports, loved hanging out with his friends, very social.
Good stuff. I got you on tape.
We're a totally active family, and sports played a huge role in Matthew, Nick, and I spending time with each other. So it was kind of like perfect world. I had two boys, 2 years apart, and it was tremendous. It was fun.
At the age of 5, the Paravan's youngest son, Matthew, experienced his first seizure. The next 2 years involved long hospital stays in both Ottawa and Toronto, separating the family for months on end.
Matthew's condition continued to deteriorate. He lost function on his left side. He slowly lost his mobility. He went from obviously running, walking, playing hockey to being in a wheelchair and not able to walk on his own. He eventually lost his speech as well. He became nonverbal. His seizures were never able to be managed and continued to escalate. Matthew typically has numerous seizures every day. On a good day, we may see 30 to 50 seizures. On a bad day, Matthew will have 200, 250 plus.
It was scary. It is still scary. When your child gets born and the doctors bring him in, he's healthy, and then the shock of, you know, having a seizure. I still freak out when he has them constantly. It's something that I still can't wrap my head around.
With so much uncertainty going on in their lives, the Paravans attempted to find some kind of normalcy. It was at that point they were introduced to Roger Neilson House.
During Matthew's last stay at CHEO in the ICU, we were asked if we would like a referral to Roger Neilson House and their pain and symptom management or palliative care team. Initially, I was unsure because I didn't really understand what services they would offer us, and the word palliative was a scary thing to hear as a parent, but I spoke to a friend who had been involved with Roger Neilson House in the past, and she convinced me that it would be a great service that would be a huge help to us moving forward. We agreed, and as soon as I said the word, within 24 hours, a team from Roger Neilson House came to visit us at CHEO to explain their programming and how they could help us and support us.
Support is exactly what they found.
The first couple of nights that he stayed here, he wasn't really very happy. I was a little nervous because it was the first time I had actually left him overnight without one of us being with him for his entire illness. One thing that Roger Neilson House did to help us adjust was they welcome phone calls from parents at any hour of the night. I could pop by here at whatever time I want when Matthew is here. I would call first thing in the morning. Sometimes I would call late at night, and it never felt like a burden to them. They were always happy to report on how Matthew was doing, what Matthew was doing. And they were also very honest. If Matthew was upset, they would tell me that. Into his first day, Matthew met Kat, who has become a big part of Matthew's time here at Roger Neilson House.
I've had the pleasure of working with Matthew probably for the past 2 years, and we've really developed a beautiful relationship.
Something that's really difficult for us with Matthew is that he's not able to be verbal, but he is very cognitively aware. He has opinions and ideas about what is happening around him, but it's very frustrating for him because most people don't know or understand how to communicate with him.
It's probably the most important part of his life, I believe. Matthew has so many things to say, and there's so many things that he wants to do.
We use communication cards, but because of its limited mobility, it takes quite a bit of practice to get comfortable with how Matthew actually uses them.
Once you provide him with an opportunity to talk, he'll talk your ear off. He'll ask you questions, and he does this cute little thing where he'll stick out his finger every time he has something to say. So once you ask him one question all day long, it's pointing out he has more and more things to say.
That for Matthew was huge, and that's in fact when he began to feel comfortable coming here, because he knew that he had a voice. He was able to say when he was upset or happy, or if there was something specific he wanted to do.
Roger Neilson House has also given Matthew an opportunity to get to know one of his idols, Chris Neil, and his wife, Caitlin.
It was immediately obvious to everybody around that Chris is very comfortable around Matthew. Matthew, even with his disabilities, some people can be nervous and unsure of how to communicate with him. Chris and Caitlin didn't hesitate for a second.
What he battles and overcomes every single day, it's inspirational to anyone. He's just a happy kid, and you ask him questions, you can joke with him, and he's no different than anyone else. He really isn't.
Matthew Paravan and his family still struggle with his illness. But at Roger Neilson House, they have found a community that they can depend on.
Without the help of the Ottawa Senators Foundation and Roger Neilson House, I don't know where we'd be. We're so grateful to have somewhere to be able to be a family together, and to feel somewhat normal again.
That's the one.
Without the Ottawa Senators Foundation, we wouldn't have any of that.
It is an honor to have Matthew the Brave in studio with us, and he has a big job along with his brother Nicholas and mom Stephanie and dad Bruno. You're going to drop the puck at center ice in a little while. But first, we're going to talk a little bit more about, we heard in the story, what Roger's House means. And Stephanie, we're all wearing the Matthew the Brave bracelets. I guess Roger's House has given you all the ability to be brave as well.
Absolutely.
In terms of Matthew and his communication, Matthew and I go, well, way back, sort of. And I know that you love to do a lot of talking, and we're going to do it, as we saw in the story, through the cards. Matthew and Stephanie will help guide. Are you excited to... Oh, you already knew what I was going to say. You're also telepathic. I asked, am I allowed to tease you tonight the way I did the other day? Yes, I am, because you're such a great sport. Thank you. And so this is my chance to let everyone know that there might be a bit of a crush with Kate and Chris Neal's daughter, Haley. Is that true? A little bit true, yeah. We had to get some romance into this story because it is a story about love. It's a story of the love that you feel at Rogers House. Stephanie, describe it for those watching, what it's meant to your family.
It's an incredible experience being involved with Rogers House. It's the people. And the people that work at Rogers House, but also the other families that are involved in Rogers House with us.
And actually, they care for the whole family. The idea is that Matthew goes and is looked after there. But Nicholas, I get the vibe that you're not only the best brother going. We could see that in the story as well. But Rogers House means a lot to you, doesn't it? Tell us about that.
Well, like, Rogers House is a fun place to be because I get to meet a bunch of other kids who can be my brother's friends, and, like, they're fun.
And for you, for all of you, and I'm sure for you, Nicholas, because Matthew's your little brother and you used to do everything physically together. To deal, and I'm sure that that's what so many of the parents who are watching at home are thinking, to deal with watching your child learn to do everything and then to have to face all of these physical challenges. Is there a counseling component at Rogers House as well that helps you, you know, handle that?
Yes, there's it's just a huge counseling part at Rush Nielsen House. There's a parent support group monthly that families can attend, but also individual counseling through the amazing social workers at Roger Nielsen House.
Mm. We're so grateful to have you here, and I know we mentioned you're about to go and drop the puck, and that's happening very soon. Bruno, in one word, your gratitude, how would you like to express it?
I'm speechless. It's an honor to be here, and I thank Rogers House, I thank Roger Nielsen House, I thank you all for making us a big part of your lives. We appreciate it.
Thank you all so much. Thanks, Matthew. We're going to Ian Mendez right now.
Leanne, thank you very much. And you know what? I thought I was going to be okay. I'd watched that story before, watching it again. It is so difficult to watch that, and yet at the same time, so inspiring and heartwarming. And it really makes you want to open up your heart and your wallet when you see something like you just saw with the Paravan family. Here's how you can help out, folks. 1-844-8-GO-SENDS. You can go online to thesendsfoundation.com. You can also use text as well. Incentives, including an 8x10 print of the Captain Eric Carlson, an 8x10 hand autographed portrait of a Sens player, and a game day used puck if you donate $500 or more. And $1,500 or more will get you an autographed jersey with a personalized message from your favorite Sens player. Let's send it. Well, take a look, and you can see here the wives and girlfriends of the Ottawa Senators. They're working the phones right now, and they would love to stay busy throughout this game. And again, the phone number 1-844-8-GO-SENDS. And maybe with a little update of where things stand right now, let's go back to Tessa Bunnell.
Thank you very much, Ian. Yes, as you saw, three of the five women busy on the phone collecting donations. Come on, let's make it five out of the five. Here's the total that we've got so far for you. Drum roll, please. We've got $35,175. Great work, everyone. This is only just the beginning, because I would like to remind you that, yes, you can continue to donate throughout the entire game. Make sure you're tuning in on intermissions as well. We have more interviews with everyone as well. We will continue to share all of these amazing stories. Game time, just minutes away. Ottawa Senators hosting the Colorado Avalanche. Ottawa looking to close the gap on the Montreal Canadiens for first in the Atlantic.